They played all the games, and thought it was time to stop playing games, and embark on a journey, to develop their own video game. Hunkered down in a dusty basement. It would be 7 grueling years, and 3 cancelled titles before the team's first game would see the light of day. This is the journey of
Alien Cybercode.
It all started back in 2010, an independent multimedia group with 3 skill sets. An amateur 3D modeler, a programmer script writer, and a sound effects music composer, none with any video game development training, only a past in developing web pages, all put their heads together in an effort to develop their first 3D title. It was the dream team, ready to embark on what they know now as the downward spiral. In the summer of 2010,
Alien Cybercode
got their hands on their first 3D engine. With this new 3D engine, the small team finally felt they could develop their first video game.
Alien Cybercode
had a passion for computers and video games, but no real guidance in the development process.
Alien Cybercode
formulated a game plan, and in the summer of 2010 they jumped into action. They quickly started programming short interactive demos into the 3D engine, and started to get a feel for it. In a few grueling months they produced a series of prototype demos featuring gameplay objectives the team wanted to accomplish, like walking forward, walking backwards, animated models and using a camera to look around in a scene. After 7 grueling months of burning midnight oil, eating horribly, and endless amounts of fixes, the time was here. The team released their first playable demo. It had all the features they were striving to accomplish. A movable walkable character, bump map textures, in-game sound effects, they even went the distance, and added a working flashlight. Here is the video of my very first gameplay demo. It was victory in the making.
Alien Cybercode
thought nothing could stop them now. They did it. All of their hard work had paid off. They had a playable demo featuring everything they wanted to accomplish. They now set their focus on their first title. Developed strictly in-house, with no name, and only a working title of Alpha 1, also known as Alpha 1. This game would take
Alien Cybercode
for all it's got, and is the start of the downward spiral of delay after delay, and cancelled games. The team shot high for Alpha 1. This game would be an open world game set in the future, with a cast of cutthroat characters banding together. After many midnight hours the team developed another playable demo, this time featuring their new character, Ben Bennett, a reporter and main character with the team's brand new third person mechanic. This was going to be the start of something big. So big the team couldn't handle the grueling workload and long hours. The game quickly grew from small to large. Then from large to massive, reaching over 100 scenes and a working folder of 16 massive gigabytes, with over 10 hours of recorded voice acting done by the team's music composer. The game quickly turned from a third-person shooter into a first-person shooter and implemented a driving system. This caused the team massive hours in conversion work. After many complications, hard drive failures and game fixes, the game was slowly and painfully being assembled. The downward spiral was in effect and taking its toll on the team. The gnat flies and the dusty basement air started having its effect on everyone. Neck aches were daily, task list endless. Now, 2 years and counting, the team was deep into development, working 7 days a week, and endless, 17-hour, shifts. They started to realize that they bit off more than they could chew. The team couldn't juggle the amount of work Alpha 1 required. The game was too large, and after multiple injuries from working on the game, yes you heard right, injuries from working on the game. Team members complained of horrible wrist aches, hand, thumb, and new vision problems due to extended hours working on Alpha 1. At this point the game went into an excessively long delay. 4 years into development and with a ton of unfinished scenes, massive amounts of dialogue to fix and scenes to clean up,
Alien Cybercode
would slip farther into the downward spiral, and the game Alpha 1 ended up being scrapped due to its excessive size. At this point, the team felt like they were put through war, tired, and defeated. Video game development demanded more than they ever could have dreamed of. An alpha build was produced but has now been lost due to multiple hard drive failures. The team complains of fatigue, tired of working with dull color palettes and depressing themes. Project Alpha 1 fades into the darkness. A year or so passes, and the team again reassembles, and is now looking to start a new video game project. Trying to avoid their dark past, the team decides their next game will have a funny cartoon look, in hopes to refresh their creative side. The team's next game will feature a young boy named Billy, his weapon of choice, a wooden baseball bat. With it, he hopes to save his planet from an alien invasion. Without a working title, Project Billy Kid starts off with a bang, and a new gameplay mode is quickly added due to its exciting playtest success. The game features a new and exciting original soundtrack, and a far leap from
Minecraft's
last title, which was dark and gloomy. Project Billy Kid goes into development for over a year. It gets good reception. The team enjoys the game but is not inspired like they were with Alpha 1. Something is just not right. The project slowly grinds to a dead stop. Months later, this game also sees the chopping block and fades into the darkness. The game is cancelled shortly after it is started. Project Billy Kid is canned, and at this point,
Alien Cybercode
is starting to feel the nasty side of game development. Over 3 years have passed, and the dream team at Mindzote has nothing to show for it, other than some poorly made alpha demos, two cancelled games, and a slew of new joint and vision problems. After another long vacation, the team reassembles and is ready to return to their bloody roots of their past. They want to produce another dark horror game. With no name, and the working title known as Project Marty is born. Learning from its past,
Alien Cybercode
digs in and completes a prototype version of the game. It quickly develops into a fairly polished version, but needs massive fixes in its framework. The team fights over different ideas. Large portions that took months to develop are cut out of the game and changed. The whole game is scrapped due to a memory error, and it is slowly and painstakingly rebuilt from scratch. This takes another 2 years. The team comes back with a new playable build, and for the first time, they take advantage of dynamic light. Mana. Project Marty will take a long journey down a complicated twist of roads, in which eventually gets the game cancelled, and is now the third cancelled title looming over
Alien Cybercode's
head. Project Marty fades into the darkness.
The Alien Cybercode
dream team goes back to focusing on their personal lives. They will later come together one last time and gather all of their efforts on one last title. It's the final countdown.
Alien Cybercode
cannot complete a working title. They will all go back to their day jobs and never look back. When the team reassembles once again, they wanted to capture the struggle and the pain they were feeling during their many years of development. It was going to be an all-out struggle, an all-out balls-to-the-wall shooter. The team didn't want to hold nothing back this time. The game would present the most complex gameplay features yet. Weapon switching, blocking, bullet time, strife jumping, and multiple hand weapons, and with over 20 enemies, the team had their work cut out for them. The team's music composer jumped right in and started releasing all his pent-up anger from failed titles of the past into
Alien Cybercode's
best soundtrack yet. A fresh new mix of original electronic and metal tracks kept the team burning through the night.
Alien Cybercode
wanted to create a fast action-packed shooter, similar to their favorite game, Quake.
Alien Cybercode.
So its new title becomes Hell's Bent on Wounded Knee. A single-player first-person style shooter with small elements of adventure, and with the ability to level up your character, fight with guns or your hands, or complete a speedrun.
Alien Cybercode.
It released its first alpha demo of Hell's Bent on Wounded Knee. It was a small playtest map, fast, and plenty of ways to die. Plenty of weapons to try. The alpha demo revealed that
Alien Cybercode
was now getting more into render effects and dynamic lighting, better programming. The game looked and played like their best yet. The game went into a grueling 3 long years of development. Multiple roadblocks and endless changes proved it to be falling behind due to many complications during production. The dream team put on their hard hats and hunkered down once more. Their past failures helped them push forward. The game kept making progress. Inch by inch, things were getting done. They didn't want to see another failed game. It had been 7 years since they first set out to make their own video game. New alpha builds became available. The game was fast and mean. Everyone had a blast playing it.
Alien Cybercode
finally had something on their hands they felt comfortable working on. An overworld map was added. New features were also added, like end level bosses, bonus stages, and a single player adventure mode, which was later removed from later versions. Hell's Bent on Wounded Knee was completed but never fully polished. A build was produced that most team members were happy with and featured most what they set out to do. It is
Alien Cybercode.
It's only game to see the light of day, and you can say, it's 7 years in the making.
Update. Hell's Bent on Wounded Knee ended up being cancelled after having issues with quality control. It's just another game that will seep into the dark void of cancelled Alien Cybercode games. After working nearly 3 years on it, only to see it cancelled, left the team defeated. Lead Dev. We had a good idea, which took way too long to produce. The only game like it at the time was Quake 3. Doom 2016 wasn't even released yet, but we took so long to make Hell's Bent on Wounded Knee that Doom 2016 came out, along with Quake Champions, and we knew at this point we were doomed. The game was cut shortly after Quake Champions. Alien Cybercode has been working on games now for 12 years and has yet to see a single public release. This has made the team feel defeated, but they don't give up. The team takes a break for a year focusing on other stuff. It's a good breath of fresh air, from the past decade of 18-hour days and a lap full of cancelled games. After a short time away from their computers, they had time to think. After the break, they dove back into development with new ideas. Lead Dev. Three more games go onto paper and into development in 2019, including Deltron City 2, which we worked on for about 7 months. We built our whole new and improved FPS mechanic during this time. The old one from Deltron City 1 was trashed. We also configured all new AI, which was a huge step, because our games in the past didn't present the best AI. Even with all these improvements, working on Deltron City 2 Alpha was draining, just due to the first one, its long 8-year span and failure. We felt like we were diving back into a bottomless rabbit hole, and we were not prepared for it again. During alpha production of Deltron City 2, Alien Cybercoat was quietly working on another project in the background. It was Arm Wrestling Reborn, a new refreshing break from their failed first-person shooters of their past. The fresh idea gained traction and had everyone willing to dive back into full-time production. Deltron City 2 production is cancelled and fades away. Dev. It was too early. At this point, Deltron City felt like an ex-girlfriend and we just wanted to move on. Working on it was painful. The team was laser-focused now and had chosen its new title for full-time production. They had to develop an arm wrestling game mechanic from scratch that would simulate a modern-era arm wrestling match. At this time, the team started studying and watched nearly a year's worth of real online arm wrestling matches. Lead Dev. We were arm wrestling fans shortly before we created the game, that's why we had the idea. There was a point where all we did every day was watch real arm wrestling matches online, from day to night. These early stages were very crude in design as the team wasn't working off any previous template. There were no making an arm wrestling video game tutorials online, so they had their work cut out for them. This would be an original mechanic, built from scratch, and tailored to fit specific ideas and external mechanics. Nearly 4 months in, an early crude playable version of the mechanic was being produced, with in-game characters performing. They had an arm wrestling mechanic that they felt would work. Many bugs were worked out as new features were added, like the ability to work out, get stronger, and deliver power presses during a match. A year into development, the game was detailed enough with full matches and playable rounds that the team was happy enough with the core mechanic to start expanding the game's locations, characters, and fine-tuning everything. Characters were made and imported, which went through a wide variety of changes before choosing the final ones. Voice actors from Deltron City joined to bring the characters to life.
I suggest you listen up. Who are you?
Yeah, let's see that picture.
Ideas were tested to bring them to life dynamically during a match. Taunting and arm break concepts were added and tuned. The game was pushing forward. Everything was going smooth and everyone was excited. Quality Control was happy enough to push the game into full production and full rollout. This was an achievement in itself to Alien Cybercoat. They had a game that finally passed the dreaded QC department. As the team were detailing the game, they brought back the music composer from Deltron City and Hellsbent on Wounded Knee, which produced the theme song for Arm Wrestling Reborn. About a year later and now nearly 2 years in production, the team was happy enough to release a build to the public. Alien Cybercoat would see their first public release in 2021. It seemed unreachable for 12 years, but Arm Wrestling Reborn is out now, available on Google Play and will be released for PC and PC Oculus platforms soon. Thanks for watching and joining us on our adventure.
Update: Alien Cybercoat was excited for the release of Arm Wrestling Reborn. To the team's dismay, the game was launched and was released to underground software distributors all over the internet, for free. Alien Cybercoat was now faced with what many developers have faced before. With that said, people still started downloading Arm Wrestling Reborn and they seemed to be having fun with it.
This is fucking astounding!
The camera,
I love this!
The camera is amazing!
Holy
it's,
fuck.
This is like exhausting me. My score rapidly drains if I stop mashing.
Alien Cybercoat poured 2 years straight of development time into Arm Wrestling Reborn, and now 2 years later, it has not even returned a day's cost of development. With Alien Cybercoat now nearly afloat and broken from their stats of their last release, they slowly start putting together a personal project Isle has been constructing on his spare time. It's a VR drum simulator, built on XR. Something totally different from their last projects, this project was fueled by Io's growing drum interest. Io, I actually made this for myself when I lost my drum set in real life, due to, well, real life issues. I made some drum covers just relaxing on my spare time with what I made, and I showed them to the guys. With nothing really on our plate at the time, other than a secret dark project, unnamed, and unannounced, well, until now. After they seen the drum covers, they both agreed we should take this idea I was working on, for myself, to full production, which we did. Throughout the years, Alien Cybercoat has been hit time and time again with hurdles in the game development field. With Arm Wrestling Reborn failing, it will be decided Alien Cybercoat will go out with a bang, and be releasing all their previously cancelled games, this year 2023. This is big news for Io, who has been fighting to get Hell's Bend on Wounded Knee and Project Alpha 1, out to the public, for almost nearly two decades now. Io, I fought for these games to be released twice. Cancelled as far back as 2004, I think it was, sitting on a single hard drive for now nearly two decades, besides a few alpha copies floating around since 2007. Now both games, although broken and in beta, alphas, both games will see the light of day.